We're going to learn about a little science today from the children's librarian at the Wollaston branch of the Thomas Crane Public Library. Amanda Pegg-Wheat has stopped on by to talk to us about ongoing stuff that goes on there. Amanda, thanks for coming by.
Thank you for having me.
Science, library, what's going on?
Science is a wonderful way for children to learn to explore the world around them, and that's something we want to encourage in the library all the time. So we started off really young. My program is aimed at like toddlers and preschoolers.
Okay.
As they do science anyhow.
Yeah,
so
true.
This is just guided.
Okay. So are these just various programs that you do throughout the year, or are there specific times that you do these?
The science program that I run at the Wollaston branch is something I do once a month. It's an evening program at the moment. We're not opposed to moving it, but at the moment it's one Wednesday evening a month.
Okay.
Usually the second Wednesday of the month. But I also run story times, and we run all sorts of other programs at the library that usually have a component that people may not think is science, but actually is. I've run a block program that seemed like a free play block time for kids. But
you mean like building blocks, right?
Oh yeah, building blocks. We had all sorts of different things. But kids are learning balance. They're learning sequencing. They're learning about patterns. So that's science. Anytime you try something new and see if it works or not, that's science.
Okay. Any particular age group that we're talking about here when you're talking about the science programs?
The science programs are geared for ages 2 and up.
Okay.
So they're aimed at younger kids, but that doesn't mean older kids can't come. It just means that the experiments and the activities are on the simple side, because you don't want something that's so complicated that a 3-year-old wouldn't be able to do it.
Sure.
Yeah.
And these, I'm assuming, are free, right?
They are completely free.
Okay.
All the programs that are library-sponsored are completely free, which we love.
And is it kind of a drop-in thing, or does folks have to sign up? Or?
It's a drop-in program. Okay. The science program is drop-in. We do have to register some of our programs, especially at the small branches, because of space issues.
Sure.
But this program, the science one, is a drop-in program. And what's nice about drop-in is it means that you're not beholden to a specific time either. So any time after like 6 to around 7:30, I'll have the materials out. Come on in, do some science with your kids. I'm always available to help out and do science with the kids myself.
Right.
And I love doing that.
Okay. And hopefully encourage them to try it at home, I'm guessing, right?
Definitely. Yeah. Everything that I put out is something that you could recreate at home. I use very simple materials. They're all things that you could buy at the supermarket or a craft store.
Okay. And thanks for stopping by and chatting with us about it. We'll take a look at those experiments next.
All right. This is a magnet bottle. It's a very simple activity that you can put together at home. This is something we did when we did magnets as a theme. And I brought it in because it's nice and colorful, so it's easy to see what happens when I take a magnet and draw it over the bottle.
Uh-huh.
Some of the things stick and some don't.
Okay.
That's because I filled the bottle up with a variety of items, which you can do at home. You don't have to use what I used. Paper clips are easy to find,
True.
So that's an easy one to do. And I also cut up some pipe cleaners and put in some beads. And I had some sparkly things from my craft materials that I added in.
Okay.
But it's just a soda bottle and some things from around the branch that I had. And the magnet is a magnet wand that we bought from a educational supply company. But
okay.
You can use fridge magnets for this.
Sure.
So as long as you have a magnet, it'll work, because the magnet will stick to the metal in the pipe cleaners. It'll stick to the metal in the paper clips. And the kids love playing with it because it's shiny and it makes a fun noise.
Yes.
And then they can try things like seeing what they can get up to the top of the bottle.
Okay.
You can also fill the bottle with water and put magnetic items in it and see if you can get something out of the bottle without reaching in or dumping out the water. So I didn't want to get your studio wet, so I didn't do that. But that's also another thing that you can do with these bottles.
Okay, and you let the kids try this right at the library?
Oh yeah, we put these out. I had a couple of these out on the tables. They had different things in them. I left a couple of magnet wands out and just let them play with them, and they had a great time with them. Got a little noisy, but we're okay with that when learning is happening. So
very good. And then you talk about the metallic properties, magnetic properties.
We ask questions.
Yeah.
And that seems to be the best way to get kids thinking about what's happening. Even the very youngest kids, when you say, okay, if you take the magnet, what sticks? And they're going to tell you what stuck and what didn't.
Sure.
And they'll keep trying and see if they can get those beads to go up, or they can get those sparkly things to go up. And when it doesn't happen, you go, so do you think those are magnetic? No.
Okay.
So you ask questions, you get them thinking about it, and that's where the science happens.
There you go. Let's take a look at our next demonstration here for science at the Wollaston branch of the Thomas Crane Library. What have you got for us?
We have a color experiment. This involves some baking soda and vinegar.
Okay, this looks like fun.
It is.
Reminds me of my tabletop volcano days back in science class.
It's the same basic principle.
Okay.
I've just added food coloring, which is also very easy to get a hold of.
Uh-huh.
Might have some in your kitchen already.
Sure.
Probably have some vinegar already. And all you have to do is add some food coloring to your vinegar. I poured these earlier and just added a drop or two of food coloring to each one. You can see they're red, yellow, and blue. So
yep.
We have the primary colors.
Okay.
I also earlier mixed some food coloring into my baking soda,
yes.
Which does take some mixing. You have to put a couple of drops in and then mix it really well. But eventually it mixes up very nice and regular. So I've got sort of pinkish right now, some light blue and some light yellow. So we're going to mix them together and see what colors we get.
Okay, so just ordinary household items here.
Very basic,
yep.
Plastic cups and a measuring spoon. The measuring spoon is just for convenience.
Okay. So that doesn't have to be exact, right?
No.
We're not baking here.
We're not baking. The chemistry is more casual.
Okay.
Here. So what we're going to do is add a little bit. We don't want to add too much baking soda to too much vinegar,
right.
Or it will be everywhere.
Sure.
So we're just going to put a little bit of the yellow in here.
So this should be done under parent supervision, obviously.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely. Fortunately, none of these are, you know, harmful if tasted, but they wouldn't taste very good.
Right, and they just could be a little messy.
Yeah, a little messy. Fortunately, if you use cups about this size
yeah.
instead of little ones, or if you do it on a plate with very small amounts,
mm-hmm.
you could put out a tray, you could put out a paper plate or
okay.
a couple of paper plates, anything with a lip on it. Just put little piles of the baking soda out and then have a little spoon and let them drop the... instead of doing what I'm doing, adding the baking soda to the vinegar,
yeah.
add the vinegar to the baking
okay.
soda instead.
Probably a white plate so you can see the color.
You
right?
definitely,
okay.
yeah. You want to definitely be able to see the color change,
right.
which is pretty cool.
Okay, so going pink to yellow here.
Yep, we're adding the pink stuff to the yellow, and we're going to see what we get. And we get orange foam,
yeah.
which is very cool.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, kids would love that.
Yeah.
yeah.
And not only does it foam orange, but when the foam goes down, you can see that the liquid is now more of an orange color
Very
than the yellow.
Very pronounced orange, yeah, okay.
Yeah. So we can try that. That was the red to the yellow.
Okay.
We're going to try a little yellow to the blue and see what we get.
Okay, so you get a little blue colored vinegar.
Yep.
Just about a quarter cup there.
Yeah.
Okay.
And let's see what we get here.
And like magic.
Green foam.
Yeah.
And who doesn't like adding something to something else and getting a reaction out of it? That's so cool. And then when it dies down, you get the green liquid.
Yeah, very pronounced green. It's unmistakable,
yeah.
actually. Yeah.
I have found that the purple doesn't work quite as well. I think I need to adjust my amounts. But
okay.
those two are super fun, and you can get the purple to work. It just takes a little trial and error, but that's science, too.
Okay, and again, it's, you know, getting the kids to ask why, right?
Yeah.
You know, why does that do that? And teaching them about, well, you've got chemical reaction
yeah.
going here. You've got your colors going here. So even a two-year-old, do you think?
Yeah, I think a two-year-old can still have fun with
yeah.
it as long as a parent is with them doing it. And what's fun is that you can do it in your house. You can do it in your kitchen.
Right.
You could pull that out, you know, one evening and just do it without a whole lot of prep work, without a whole lot of time investment, and then ask your kid, why do you think it happened?
Sure.
And then you're doing science.
And then, you know, by the time they get to the appropriate grade level and they're doing these, they can say, oh, I've already done that.
Yeah. And they've already got a good grounding in, like, the scientific method.
Sure.
What do you think is going to happen? Do it. What happened? Did it do what you wanted it to
right.
do? Did it not do what you wanted it to do? That's the scientific method right there. But
all
they're
right.
learning it as very young children because they already do it. Just have to guide them a little bit.
A lot of fun. And again, these are Wednesday nights at the Wollaston branch?
One Wednesday night a month.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Amanda. It's been a lot of fun.
Thank you for having me.
You are very welcome. And don't forget, if you'd like more information about this or any of the programs at the Thomas Crane Library, visit their website, thomascranelibrary.org.